Hello and welcome everyone. In this video, we are going to introduce Docker for our project so that we can have two containers, one Node.js and one MySQL container, and Node.js container can talk to our MySQL container. Okay, for this, we are going to add Docker file and Docker compose file and Docker ignore file. Docker ignore file is just to avoid putting things in Docker containers which we don't want. Okay, so let's create them. So first of all, in the root folder, we will create a Docker file. Okay, that Docker file will be a simplified Docker file. What we will do is we will just fetch the latest node carbon image. Okay, I think this should be, we don't need semicolon. Okay, work dir. So we just need to follow the path. I mean, how to write a Docker file. Working directory is we'll keep simple. User src app. And then we just copy, this is a copy command to copy your code to your user src app, and we'll do run npm install. These are predefined commands and we'll just expose a port. You need to use expose, and we'll be exposing 3000 port, and if you have a debug port 9209 or whatever you want. And finally, what command you wanted to run, this will come here, npm run debug we have. Or npm run start, let's say, because that is starting our project. It should be caps. Okay, so this is our Docker file. Similarly, we can create a Docker compose file. Docker compose.yml, and it will have both the services. One is a Node.js and one is a MySQL. So version 3, and here we have all the services. In the services, our first service will be the node service. We will define all the attributes for this, like build, and we are building the node with the Docker file which is already there. And then port mapping, you can say, is 3000 of host port is mapped with 3000 of container port. And here we have a volume mapping. So volume mapping is the current working directory is mapped with user src app. And it depends on MySQL, because we are going to have another container which is MySQL. So now we can create an image for MySQL. This is another service. So MySQL, for this we can define, okay, what image you want. It's a container image, we are not going to build it. MySQL, you can say 5.7 standard image. And we can define the ports mapping. Ports mapping is okay, 3306 of host port is mapped with 3306 container port. And here we can define the environments. Okay, here we have, in the environments there are different attributes we have to define, like username, password and all. So this environment we are passing to the database. Always just take care of the indentation, otherwise we'll be in trouble. Okay, after declaring environments, we can also do the volume mounting so that our data can be persisted. Data db, this is mount with user lib MySQL, var lib MySQL. Okay, and then you can just define the volume mapping. So typically this is how our Docker compose look like. Here we have a Node.js and MySQL image. So this Node.js will be talking to MySQL from this configuration. User src app. Okay, so you can see the volume mapping is everything from this current working directory will be mapped to the user src app. And we also need to create a Docker ignore file. what Docker ignore file is doing is it is just telling what node to be mounted in the Docker container. So this is standard. We are not going to mount Docker compose definitions, Docker ignore dot git folder and all, because they are not going to be used. What we need on the Docker container is our code which we are going to build and run. Okay, so just look at it, Docker compose definition, this is how we write it. You can add a many services here, and this is just a data mapping, so that once you do a restart and Docker compose down and up, your data is still available in the Docker volume. So whatever the database and tables you have created, that will still be accessible to you until unless you do Docker volume pruning, which is just going to wipe out your all the volumes created for this container. And this Docker compose file will create a local network so that your Node.js and MySQL can talk to each other because they are in the same Docker compose definitions, and the default network will be created. So Node.js service will be accessing the MySQL as a host. We are not going to access MySQL from localhost colon 3306. We will be accessing as a MySQL as a host, and port number is 3306, and these are the configuration which will be passing about the database. Okay, so in the next video we'll start the Docker compose and we'll just run our MySQL and Node.js there.